Man, it's so exciting to have this next guest back on with us. It's great to be I'm sure he just loves doing this and probably misses doing it as much as I have, and it's great to be able to sit down with Alex Snitker and catch up with what's going on. How are you doing, my friend?
I'm doing very well, Brandon, and I'm also very happy that we're back on doing this again, because it's always fun to have a good discussion with you.
Absolutely. Let's just do some hard news and have some fun, because I don't know about you, man. We got something really important that happened, and we're too busy talking about the president's health and his mental health and having, you know, CNN reporter and ABC reporters just making fools of themselves and then trying to deny that they're biased. And this is crazy.
Well, yeah, but the one thing that you did say there, though, about the proving that they were biased is that what happens every time is you have this glaring example of the media bias, even in something as innocuous as having a health check.
That's true, right? We can't even, like, have honest questions from Dr. Jackson. We ask, well, what about Alzheimer's? Well, what about this? How can I don't know that I believe you, because he eats McDonald's and Kentucky Fried Chicken all the time. Who comes up with this nonsense? Are they just that far delusional, or are they actually, I don't know, looking for a story? Can you even explain it away?
There's no way to explain it away, and they're either A, just trying to find something to nab him on, or the Trump derangement syndrome is real. It's one of the two.
Well, I've been an advocate of the Trump derangement literally since within the 12 hours of this man being elected. And neither of you were supportive of Trump. Neither of us, as far as I know, voted for Trump. But we can sit back and go, you people are absolutely insane about this guy. And I guess it's just another example to that, as far as I see.
Yeah, no, I agree with you. You're right. And neither one of us voted for him. We didn't support him during the primary. We actively opposed him for the election itself, but he did get elected. And at that point, you move towards the, you know, well, let's talk about the policies that are going to be implemented because of that. And instead of doing that, and this is where the media, I think, has done the biggest disservice to the American public, is that instead of going down the policies and really kind of taking a clinical look at it and analyzing it and providing the news, they went off into this whole other direction of wild conspiracy theories. And, you know, the tinfoil hats have definitely moved on to CNN and MSNBC. They are wearing it, they got the strap on, and they're ready to go.
That's so true. That's so true. We need to actually have specialty tinfoil hats, right, so we can get like a tinfoil hat that they have to wear with the hammer and the sickle with the Russian collusion hat. And then we have to have some sort of hat that has like a symbol on top with this whole mental health. He's not capable of mentally even doing this kind of stuff hat. Don't you think we have different hats? It would be even more fun that way.
Well, I think that you're really missing out. They needed to be gender neutral, so you need about 35 different kinds depending on where you are at and what you self-identify as. So I think you're not being nearly specific enough. The tinfoil hats now have many more flavors that you get to choose from.
Wow. Yeah. Thanks for calling me out for not being politically correct, like, at all. Yes. Thank you very much for that. Meanwhile, there really is a serious story, right? We have this Chinese former CIA spy, basically, right? He's got a ledger. He's got notes in his margins of his book. He's got links to safe houses. We have proof from a New York Times, not the most conservative bastion of sources, of operatives in China being murdered during the Obama administration when this guy was allegedly doing these things. And the FBI had him at one point and then just let him go.
Yes, this is the dangerous part of having a media that is not focused on, you know, looking at the real news stories, is that when you have a story come out like this, that it almost is pushed by the wayside. I mean, if you look at just, you know, and some of this is the public's own doing, so you can't just blame the mainstream media for this. It is the kind of news that the public wants to consume that is also a part of this. But, you know, I think that you have to, if the media were to focus and put more onus on the important stories, I think that you would have a general public that would be more focused on the important stories instead of keep feeding them sweets and keep feeding them sweets and then wondering why the kid gets fat.
Well, it's so true, obviously. When we saw this during the Obama administration, right, you and I would just bang our heads against the wall over and over again going, look, you got to at least try to be reasonably investigated. If you got to be reasonably interested in trying to hold some feet to the fire, and they actually proved time and time again they were not, and they actually would give cover. And obviously, to even see Hillary Clinton move as far as she did, to even be considered, and those kinds of, just showed how bad they had gotten up to that point.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, no. It in a lot of ways, it's its own doing. I was actually at a Tiger Bay event locally here, which is where where they bring in guest speakers and things like that. And one of the guest speakers that they had was one of the local editorial writers, Adam Smith. He writes for Politics in the Tampa Bay Times.
Yep.
And one of the things that he was complaining about was the rise of alternative media. And he was complaining that these, you know, all these people that are putting out these stories, they're not credentialed. You know, they're not doing it the way we used to do it in the past. However, if they were doing their job, then the mainstream media would be not looked at with a lesser favorability than cockroaches. I mean, it's their own fault, and I don't think that they've taken the time to self-analyze where the problem lies, and instead trying to, you know, well, you pesky people are just out looking for news in other places instead of what we tell you about.
Yeah.
This is just another example of that.
Boy, that hits close to home. I have two stories I can share with you, too. The first is how they sneer down their nose at me because I'm not a credentialed journalist through their networks as I even just review a movie in a seat next to them. In fact, one of them made a snide remark about who these so-called media people are in front of my wife, and I actually thought my wife was going to lose it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, they hate... They despise the people that they don't think that you should have a legitimate voice. They think that their voice means more than yours does, and that, you know, this is why one of the greatest things about the rise of alternative media has been is that you now are getting a different perspective than what you would normally get, and they don't like that. They don't want the competition. I mean, they don't want to have to compete against people like yourself because you're able to give out an opinion and you're not having to talk to editorial writers or talk to you don't have a boss, and they have a boss, and their boss makes them do certain things. And they're very, in all honesty, I think that they're jealous more than anything else, is that they're not, you know, they don't want to, they haven't gone and done it on their own. You have. And that jealousy kind of lends itself to the kind of reactions that you get.
Yeah, a little bit of that. I definitely can see that. And definitely because they actually kind of have had moments where I've interacted with them and they seem confused that I don't have a boss. They seem confused that I am on my own. And they also seem put off by the fact that I'm very transparent, that I have a bias. And I'll say to them, I said, well, of course you have a bias. You're a human being. Everyone has a bias. The fact that you won't admit it is the problem. And they get so ticked off when you start to call them out from that angle.
No, absolutely they do, because they realize that you're right and that there's nothing that they can really do about it because, you know, and again, I don't, in some ways I don't fault them because they're dependent on their paycheck. And if you are hired by someone else to do a job, then you do have to take, you know, the creative or the instructions that your boss gives you, you know, but you're doing it a different way. And that is the way that is, I think that's the way of the future though. It's not they're part of the past. And every time, you know, I'm sure the horse and buggy dealers were mad that cars were coming out. And, you know, sure. Luckily they didn't have the monopoly force of government to stop it from happening, or we'd still be, you know, walking around, you know, horse dung on the streets.